In science fiction movies, TV, and books, a popular trope is for humans to suddenly find themselves through the use of time travel or similar means millions of years in the past. Upon arriving, these people suddenly encounter strange and now extinct creatures such as flying reptiles called pterodactyls, towering non-avian dinosaurs, or even floating circular shells known as ammonites. However, so many of these science fiction scenarios contain a major problem which most people do not immediately think of. If you were to have randomly gone back in time to a point on Earth since the first animal evolved 700 million years ago, there would be an 82% chance that you would simply drop dead within 48 hours, and a portion of this percentage would be lethal within minutes to seconds. The reason? Simply put, the atmosphere would have been toxic with too little or too much oxygen as a percentage of the atmosphere being highly lethal. Humans can only breathe oxygen during the long term at concentrations of between 19.5 and 23.5%, with the current percentage of oxygen in the atmosphere being 21%. And yet, the amount of oxygen in the atmosphere during the last 700 million years has varied from as low as 2.86% to as high as 30.57%. This extreme range did not only lead to the extinction and development of many species, but also some unusual phenomena such as a time during which fires were completely impossible. Before I elaborate on that point, when exactly could a hypothetical time traveler go back in Earth's geologic history and be able to breathe permanently unaided? Well, the entirety of the last 39 million years are safe. The only time you would have been able to witness non-avian dinosaurs would have been 83 to 66 million years ago, including the extinction event which wiped them out. You could also have witnessed Earth's worst mass extinction event caused by the Siberian Traps flood basalts 254 to 248 million years ago, or view the vast Carboniferous forest between 342 and 328 million years ago. You could also have witnessed the life of the early Devonian period 404 to 395 million years ago, or the emergence of the first land animals during the Silurian between 439 and 418 million years ago. But to see the life of the Cambrian, you would need to go into the ocean, as no plants or animals existed between 528 and 508 million years ago. However, I want everyone to take this chart with a grain of salt, as I personally suspect that oxygen levels in parts of the Cretaceous and the majority of the Jurassic period are too low in this diagram. Why? The prevalence of wildfire. Above 16% oxygen, fire can occur and spread, with wildfires spreading at insanely high levels above 23%. However, at between 15 and 16%, there isn't enough oxygen for fire to spread, although isolated spot fires can form. But below 15% fire and fire spread is completely impossible. One record that has been used to quantify the level of oxygen in the atmosphere is the prevalence of ancient charcoal which needs fire to form. Thus, if oxygen levels were to drop below 15%, you would expect no charcoal to exist. And this is exactly what occurred around 380 million years ago, creating a so-called charcoal gap as oxygen levels dipped as low as 13.3%. This chart suggests that a similar complete gap of charcoal should exist in the Jurassic, and yet this is not the case. Let's now look at the high and low points of oxygen during the last 700 million years. The initial rise of oxygen 1.4 billion years ago caused the oxygenation of the deep sea, and as this increased, it eventually led to the development of animal life with sponges, and then a widespread diversification of life occurred in the Ediacaran and Cambrian periods as levels continue to rise. The low point around 445 million years ago marks a late Ordovician mass extinction event, which itself was likely caused by a major flood basalt province. Flood basalts also caused a drop in oxygen levels around 250 and 190 million years ago, the former of which resulted in the extinction of insect megafauna. Insect megafauna, such as a 2-foot-wide dragonfly which weighed as much as 1 pound, only rose to prominence because of increasing oxygen levels around 300 million years ago. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, John Karen, for supporting this channel.